Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Morgan and I am obsessed with luxury skincare. On this channel, I am constantly doing luxury skincare reviews and talking to you guys about different luxurious products and skincare routines. In today's video, I am going to be talking about the do's and don'ts of the luxury skincare game. You guys ask me a ton of questions all the time and I'm always answering them, but then I just decided, you know what, I'm gonna put some of my outlooks and thoughts on the luxury skincare game and really compile a list of do's and don'ts for you guys. Luxury skincare is expensive. You know, a lot of people are terrified to spend $200 on a moisturizer, and I totally get that. So I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of tips and tricks on what to do when you're starting your luxury skincare routines. Step one, something that you do is save your money for your skincare. You guys don't have to be super wealthy or like rich to be able to buy skincare that celebrities use, like La Mer. A lot of people will say to me, oh my gosh, or I hear people are saying about me, she's using skincare celebrities use. Like, how is she affording this? Like, it's because I save. I truly make it a goal of mine to save my money to purchase a $200 to $300 moisturizer. It's just something that I prioritize in my life and I save for. So that's always something that you need to do before you start a luxury skincare routine. Step number two that you should be doing for luxury skincare is researching brands that have the best reputation. So when you guys are ready to go drop a couple racks on a skincare routine, it's very important that you research the brand that you're investing in, because guys, luxury skincare is an investment for your skin and you want to make sure that you're investing in the best skincare brands that you possibly can. So when I was researching all different types of skincare, La Mer just kept coming up and just people either hating it or loving it. And I was just researching and seeing what my skin was doing as a result and what I can get and what luxury skincare brand I felt best represented my skin type and my needs. So when you're talking about brands like La Mer, Sisley Paris, La Prairie, Clay de Peau, these are all brands from different parts of the world. Clay de Peau is marketed as French but has an underlying Japanese culture and background. Then you have La Prairie that's made in Switzerland. Then you have Sisley Paris that's obviously made in France. Then you have La Mer that was originated in France but is being made in America from Canadian sea kelp. So it's a bunch of different concepts and you really need to pick the brand that's going to best suit your skin type. And again, when you're spending this much money on luxury skincare, you really need to research the type of brand that you're going to be purchasing. Then the next step is to decide which products work best for your skin type. So if you have a skincare concern, you really need to shop by skincare concern. A lot of the times, people will try to buy whatever their favorite influencer is using at the moment, which is great if you're in the skincare game. But if you have extremely, extremely oily skin, you definitely need to be shopping for products that are going to be best used for oily skin. We don't want to be dropping $300 on a moisturizer that is not the best for our skin type. You guys, always shop by your skincare needs, not by somebody else's skincare needs, especially in the luxury skincare game, because we're looking for maximum benefits. And then the next step is honestly, which concept of skincare do you want to involve yourself with? As I was saying previously, there's Japanese skincare, there's Korean skincare, there's Swiss skincare, there's Parisian skincare, there's American skincare, and all have very different skincare concepts and all very different proprietary ingredients that they view and believe is best for your skin type. So always look into the brand's origins and where the brands are made from and the reasons why they're creating the specific skincare products that they're creating. That can also help you decide which luxury skincare brand or brands you would like to invest your money in. Also, another thing that I think is a very good idea is if you decide on a brand and you decide on which concept of skincare you want to invest in, definitely always look at the brand's cult classic favorite product. So when you're shopping luxury skincare, try to go old luxury skincare. Skincare that's been around for decades. Skincare that has stood the test of time and that is really showing results over a long-term period. Always try to search for your top brand's favorite cult classic product. So as an example, Creme de La Mer is La Mer's cult classic product that really put La Mer on the map. You guys, always shop cult classics like the Sisley Black Rose Cream. That's tested and tried and true and people love it. So if you're new to the luxury skincare game, try to start with a cult classic and see how you like that, because that's a good depiction of what the brands are capable of. Step number six of the do's in luxury skincare is save your receipts. If you invest in a skincare brand and for some reason it's just not agreeing with your skin or you're feeling like you're not getting the best benefits that you should be for its price, return the product. Return the product. There's nothing wrong with returning a product and saying, listen, this broke my skin out. This irritated my skin. This is just not working. Just not working for me. Keep your receipts and return the products and put that money into a different skincare brand that may work for your skin. There's nothing wrong with doing that. Now, the don'ts of luxury skincare. Let's get it started and let's spill some tea. So the don't number one, no trending products. You guys, there is always something in the skincare game where people are just trending, and it's just around and it's really hot for that specific year. A couple years ago, it was all the very long Korean skincare steps. Now it's turning into skinimalism where it's very minimal. You guys, when you're buying luxury skincare, try not to feed into the trends because they are just trends and different ideas of ways of marketing. Try products and try skincare routines that work for your skin. Ignore the trends of the year and just focus on what's actually working for you. Step number two, don't think that you could find a dupe for a luxury skincare product at the drugstore. Before I started my luxury skincare game, I was always trying to find things that were cheaper, that I felt like I can get the maximum benefits out of without spending all that money. And I did, of course, try the Nivea cream by La Mer, or that's supposed to be La Mer's dupe. And guys, it broke me out. It made my skin itch and it was awful. Then when I tried the real La Mer with the real Miracle Broth, my skin completely transformed, and here I am today with the whole channel dedicated to La Mer and luxury skincare. And then of course I went into the makeup game, and then I'm a big La Mer lover. But guys, these skincare brands, especially luxury, their proprietary ingredients are made with a certain standard that these luxury companies can provide that the drugstores just are not providing for you. Don't think and don't gyp your skin on good ingredients by thinking that you can get a dupe at the drugstore. It's just not gonna work for you. And I just think that it's a completely different concept of skincare, and to be saying that drugstore skincare is working like La Mer is honestly just a flat out lie. And if you want to buy yourself drugstore skincare, buy it because you want that specific brand. Don't buy it because you think it's gonna be like La Mer, because it's not. And that goes for a bunch of other skincare brands. Step number three that you should not do is buy an entire luxury skincare routine upfront and all at once. One, it's going to be very, very pricey for you. You're gonna be well over $1,000 invested into a full line of skincare that may not work for your skin. One, it's not very cost effective. And two, you may be missing out on other opportunities on other products that might work better. So let's just say, since I'm La Mer, let's just say you are just starting out luxury skincare shopping and you just said, you know what? I'm gonna buy the whole La Mer line, I don't care, and just hope it works, right? It may work for your skin, it may not work for your skin. You may need a retinol. Maybe the Miracle Broth just isn't working for you and you need a retinol in your skincare routine. Well, La Mer doesn't sell retinol in their skincare products. There is no retinol product in any of the La Mer lines. How are you, like, then you're kind of missing out on that opportunity. So really take your time and invest your money where you think it's going to best suit your skin type. I know a lot of these brands say that you need to follow each step of their skincare routines for maximum benefits, which I do semi agree with. But I also think there's nothing wrong with mixing products and concocting your own personal luxury skincare cocktail that is going to work best for your skin. And then of course, step number four, buying products without researching them. Again, kind of similar to what I've been saying, if you're not researching skincare brands and you're not researching what's in these products or why they're being made or where they're being sourced, it's just not gonna work best for your skin. And in return, you're going to be left with an ineffective skincare routine for your skin type because you didn't take the time to research the pros and cons of each product. Then step number five of things that you shouldn't do with luxury skincare is keeping products that aren't working for your skin. Some people will try a moisturizer, some people will try a serum, and guess what? It's just not working out for them, and then they kind of brush it off to the side and they never return it, and it just kind of builds dust on their vanity, and there's like $300 wrapped into skincare that's not being used because they're not returning it. And it's basically a missed opportunity to buy a product that does work for you. So never hoard luxury skincare products that are not working for your skin. And then last but not least, step number six is don't buy another luxury skincare product for a specific step when you haven't completed your first product. Now, financially, it's not smart to buy five different luxury skincare moisturizers and use a different one every day, right? You're never gonna get the maximum benefits of these moisturizers if you're not completing them and getting the full picture. You guys, Augustinus Bader wasn't better, wasn't my favorite moisturizer, but I bought it from a store that I don't live near, so I couldn't return it. So guys, guess what I did with it? I finished it. I used it to completion and got the whole picture. Now it's going into an empties video. And I didn't buy a luxury skincare moisturizer to replace it because I needed to finish my Augustinus batter first. I got my money's worth. I have a very clear understanding of what the product is capable of. And I didn't waste and invest money before not finishing another product. You guys always need to be finishing your skincare products to make sure you're getting the whole picture and seeing the maximum benefits of each moisturizer. You guys, I hope this video was helpful to you. This is the end of my list. I hope you guys are finding the best luxury skincare products that you possibly can. Guys, all of my recommendations is based off of my skin type, my knowledge, what I'm trying and what I'm using. And guys, I fully acknowledge that something that might be working for my skin might not work for your skin. And guess what? It's okay. Try a different product. There's nothing wrong in saying, you know what? This really worked for Morgan Talks, but it's not working for me. I need a different moisturizer. And for that, I totally respect you because we have to be not wasteful of products that we're buying. And we also have to make sure that saving our money and investing our money into things that work is really high priority on our list because we would never like to be wasteful. You guys, if you haven't done so already, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram for updated skincare routines and products throughout the week. Also, I like to share my outfits and fashion. And you guys, I hope you guys are having a wonderful day and good luck on finding the best skincare products for your routines. Also, make sure to watch the other videos within my channel because there are a ton of reviews on a lot of luxury skincare products that you guys can watch to help you determine if that's a product that you would like to purchase or not. Love you guys. Bye.